Block time. Here's what's up. So block time is defined as how long each new block takes to be added to the blockchain. That's it. Thanks for watching. I'm being told there's more. So check this out. In most cases, the block time is predetermined by the original designers of the system. Bitcoin takes an average of 10 minutes for a new block to be added. Compare that to Ethereum, which only takes 10 to 19 seconds, or even coins like ARK clocking in at 8 seconds. So how does this affect you, and why should you care? For regular users like you and me, it determines how fast transactions will be confirmed on the blockchain. Fast block times, faster transaction confirmations. Slower block times, slower transaction confirmations. Right now you're probably thinking, yeah, so why wouldn't I only want fast block times? Well, what you might not know is slow block times also have their own advantages over their speedier cousins. If a block time is slower, like in Bitcoin, it can become more decentralized, meaning it can have more nodes around the world coordinating to match up and verify the transaction. Decentralization isn't a yes or no thing in blockchains. There's a level to it, and different chains make their own balance. Don't take this as fast block times being bad, it's just a different way of doing a decentralized system. In the end, both fast and slow block times offer that beautiful decentralized system we know and love. I'm Spiz, and you're watching the video channel of MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. Follow us and subscribe, join our Discord, and get your free account at marketsquare.io. See you next time.